Yeah, I'm not famous just for this stuff. I don't know why.
Good morning.
Good morning.
A verse from Psalm 122. I was glad when they said to me, "Let us go to the house of the Lord." So I hope you're glad to be here this morning in God's house. Welcome to St. Mary's, and a special welcome to Millie May and her family and friends who are here for this very, very special day of baptism. Dobrho ranku I laskavo prosimo do Svetoji Mariji.
That was Ukrainian, just to have some Ukrainian friends with us.
And indeed a special welcome to those joining us online, wherever you are around the world. I do hope you'll feel part of the service here this morning. You at least have one advantage in that you are likely to reach the end of the service without getting splashed by water. That's not something I can guarantee for the rest of the people here, and I don't just mean Millie May. When you came in, I hope you received the Connect leaflet, which has the service for us to follow today, and the words that you see in bold, those are the words that we sing together. So let's turn to that now. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
In the beginning God created the heavens and the earth, and it was very good. Those are two well-known verses from the first book of the Bible, and now some verses from the book of Job. Ask the animals, and they will teach you. The birds of the air, and they will tell you. Ask the plants of the earth, and they will teach you. The fish of the sea will declare to you. Who among all these does not know that the hand of the Lord has done this?
In his hand is the life of every living thing, and the breath of every human being.
So let's sing our first hymn. It's a real hymn of encouragement, because we live in a world where there's so much darkness. We want to live by the light of Christ and spread that light in the dark places around us. Let's sing, longing for light, we wait in darkness. Christ be our light.
Thank you.
slow to speak and slow to become angry, because human anger does not produce the righteousness that our God desires. Therefore, get rid of all moral filth and evil that is so prevalent, and humbly accept the word planted in you which can save you. So do not merely listen to the word and so deceive yourselves. Do what it says. Anyone who listens to the word but does not do what it says is like someone who looks at his face in the mirror and, after looking at himself, goes away and immediately forgets what he looks like. But whoever looks intently into the perfect law that gives freedom and continues in it by not forgetting what they have heard, but by doing it, they will be blessed in what they do. This is the word of God.
Our next hymn asks God to change our lives from the inside out through the power of his love. Let's stand and sing, and afterwards we'll remain standing for the gospel reading.
To Mark.
Glory to Christ our Savior.
confess then that the disciples rebuked them. When Jesus saw this, he was indignant. He said to them, "Let the little children come to me, and do not hinder them, for the kingdom of God belongs to such as these. Truly, I tell you, anyone who will not receive the kingdom of God like a little child will never enter it." And so he welcomed the children, took them in his arms, placed his hands on them, and blessed them. Give thanks to the Lord for this is glorious gospel.
Praise to Christ.
Good morning. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you that we can come into your house and that your Son has taught us that we are children of your household and that you are the God who welcomes us in. Amen. I think all my children are up the back. Any of the children want to come and join us? Is Millie me up there?
Millie Mee's here.
Oh, there you are. Who's coming to join me? Anybody coming to join me up the front? Oh, one, two, three. You coming up the front? George can come too. George is a big kid. Yeah.
It's all right.
Just come up here. That's a bit safe. Let's come. Let me come. There we go. Welcome. Who likes getting presents? You like getting presents, do you? Hiya, you're welcome. You come. Oh, hello. Oh, you're growing up fast. Oh, Daddy, don't leave me up. Oh, come on, Daddy.
Sit,
come and join us. Anyway, who likes presents? I like presents. Anybody else like presents? Yeah. You know, we read from God's special book. You might not have been listening. I don't think I was listening. One of the verses that we're reading says that every good and perfect present comes from God above. So I've got a present. Would you like to open the present? Would you like to take a lid off it? Right, take a lid off. You know, God comes to us like a gift. What's in there? What is it? It's another box. And sometimes God's like a mystery. We have to keep unpacking, getting to know what God is like. Can you lift this one? Oh no! What is it? Is it another box? Is it another box? God's difficult. You know, we struggle to understand God because God's like a mystery. What about this one? You want to try this one? Oh, what's that? What is it? Hold it up so everybody can see it. Can everybody see it? Well, I'll hold it up even higher. There you go. If we keep looking for God, we will find God. And we will find that God is love. And God gives good gifts to those he loves. Now, Millie Mee, this is your special day. So you get a very special gift. This one you get to keep. Okay? So this is a gift to you from God, and you can open it now. You want to open it now? Yeah, probably sellotaped it too hard. Do this. Rip that bit. You get that bit. So God is a mystery, and it takes time to unpack what God is like. But eventually we find out that God is love. And God is love, and he shows us his love in many different ways. Oh, where is it? Are you in there yet? Have you got there? Is it in there? Are you sure? Have you got it? And we find out more about God's love. You want your hand pulled up high? You find out more about God's love in his good book called the Bible. And this one's full of stories that you can learn to read as you grow up and help you.
What'd you say?
So, thank you. Thank you to God for his love. Because a lot is a mystery sometimes. And sometimes it's like you open a box and you think, what? At God's heart is love. Love for all of us. And we welcome in people who turn to God and we baptise them. And that's what we're just about to do. We're going to put water over you. Is that okay? Can we put water over you?
Yeah.
So we're going to, I think we're going to say some prayers. We're going to talk to God. And then we're going to come to the baptism. Okay, and go back to your folks. Okay? Well done. Thank you, Millie, mate. Thank you, children.
Now I'm going to come and lead us in our prayers this morning.
Lord God, Father of all people, we pray for the whole family of your church. Grant that we and all your people may be built up in our faith and show in our lives the love we see in Jesus. Bless all those who took part in the Dalkeith Churches Together barbecue over Friday and Saturday. Let your Holy Spirit support us all, and may all Christians stand in hope that your kingdom of love will come. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for our country and the many freedoms which we enjoy. We pray for Charles, our king, and for those who govern in his name. Give them health and strength, wisdom and courage, so that they may carry out their many duties in the best interests of all people. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for Millie as she's baptized today. Her parents, Natalie and George, and all the relations and friends who will be part of her future. We pray for children and young people as they start a new academic year. We think of children who are spending their first hours away from home in nursery or preschool. Children who are returning to school to face new challenges and new experiences. Young people about to start college or university for the first time and finding their values tested and their horizons widened. Those taking up apprenticeships and those who have not yet found any clear direction for their future. We think of all children and young people, praying that they may benefit from the best in our society and find a society worthy of their potentials. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we thank you for giving so much for us to enjoy in the world. Open our eyes to see all the beauty around us as summer turns to autumn. We thank you for the glorious colouring of the trees, for falling leaves that reveal the strength of the branches, for the harvest that brings gratitude for the bounty of our land, for this change of seasons that reveals the circle of life. God of all seasons, as you transform the earth, transform us by your Spirit. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for those whose lives have been shattered by war and by natural disaster. We hold in our hearts families forever changed by injury, grief and loss. We ask for your blessing on all those who've lost homes, livelihoods, security and hope. And we pray for the work of relief agencies and those providing assistance. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, surround with your love all who are ill, in hospitals, at home, or wherever they may be. Give them courage, hope, and peace, and the knowledge that you are present in their weakness, pain, and suffering. May the skills and knowledge of those who care for the sick be fully used to help and to heal. We pray especially for those who have no one to help them, that in their loneliness they may know that you are with them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father of all, we pray for those we love but no longer see. We rejoice in your assurance that they are with you in heaven, fully restored to vigour and health, enjoying your presence and eternal bounty. Heavenly Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
So we ask you to come and to join with us around the font as we come to baptise Millie May. Your turn.
Right, come on.
You coming again?
And
you come and join me.
And then.
You come and join me. Here we go. Oh, we go. I'm afraid of the See, they're all shy. Right, you ready? Anyway, Millie, we welcome you here. You've got your mummy.
You've got your grandkids, look at you. You've got grandkids too. People are going to promise that they're going to be there for you throughout your life.
To help you.
To guide you and point you in the right direction. So, I joined you up at the front.
Because
we come to remember
that after Jesus died, which was sad, for a little bit, he rose again.
And then on the day of Pentecost, he blessed
the people by sending
a gift of the Holy Spirit. And then Apostle Peter proclaimed God's call to everyone. When he urged his hearers to repent
and
be baptized in the name of Jesus for the forgiveness of sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. This promise is to you and to your children, and to all who answer the Lord's call to come and follow him.
Natalie and George, as the guardians of Millie, do you accept?
Parents,
grandparents,
grandparents.
The Christian life means turning from evil and turning to Christ. Therefore, I ask you these questions. Do you
renounce evil?
I renounce evil.
Do you repent of sin?
I repent of sin.
Do you turn to Christ?
Turn to Christ.
Will you follow Christ?
I will follow Christ.
Parents and grandparents, and the people of God together, do you believe in God the Father who made the world?
We believe.
Do you believe in God the Son who redeemed humanity?
We believe.
Do you believe in God the Holy Spirit who gives life to God's people?
We believe.
This is the faith of the Church.
This is our faith.
We believe in one God,
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Parents and godparents, of those who will love and care for Millie May, will you continue in the Apostles' teaching and in the fellowship in the breaking of bread and the saying of prayers? Will you proclaim good news by word and deed, serving Christ in all
people?
Will you work for justice and peace, honouring God in all of his creation? This is the task of the Church. This is our task, to live and work for the kingdom of God. Thankfully, me. Come on, see this.
Want to see? Oh! Can you see what's in?
It'll make it easier. I'll take the water.
Oh, there we go. Oh, there we go. See, what's in there?
Is that water? You want to make sure everybody else knows it's water. So make sure everybody else knows it's water. Right, you're not for it. You're going to soak everybody. Go on, soak all of it. Let's soak all of it. There you go. You've got to do better than that. You've got to go. There we go.
He's going to baptize you. And get a position.
Go into your redress. Keep your lip dry. Ready?
No! Tell you what, you do me. You pull me.
Right. Right. You want to do mommy as well? Right, here we go. You ready? You want to go for? You ready? This is on you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and as we bless you with the sign of the cross. Amen. We see. Millie, you are sealed by the Holy Spirit in battle, and marked as Christ's own for us.
Amen.
May the Spirit of God be in you, wisdom and understanding keep you, the power of God encircle you, and God's truth lead you into freedom.
Amen.
I give you
a candle.
That's your candle. You want to hold it? Don't blow it out yet. Just hold it. And Millie, may the light of Christ scatter the darkness from your heart and mind.
Christ is going for you to guide your steps. Christ be within you.
God has received you by baptism into the great family of the Church. We welcome you.
We will care for you.
We will share our faith with you. We used water to cleanse. Well, we've done the water, that's okay. We've used oil because in our scriptures, oil is used in the scriptures. And Millie means a special child of God. And we're given her a candle to remember her to walk in the ways of light. Because God brings us to a place of peace, and so we share the peace together. Renewed in the Spirit by baptism, we meet in Christ.
Let us share with the
Jesus. A grand applause for me. Give them one a second. So as we make our way back, we sing our hymn, "Search Me, O God, and Know My Heart Today."
To the Lord and say together, yours, Lord, is the praise, the power, the glory, the splendor, and the majesty. For everything in heaven and on earth is yours. All things come from you, and of your own we live. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Worship and praise belong to you, O God. By your holy word you brought order out of chaos. You divided light from darkness and created the heavens and established the earth. You divided the sea from the dry land and caused all life to come into being. You formed us in your own image and entrusted us with the priesthood of your creation. In Christ your holy word became flesh and took our human form and lived among us and through dying on the cross overcame sin and death that creation might be restored in him. As children of your redeeming purpose, with all your creatures throughout space and time, we offer you our praise together with angels and archangels and the whole company of heaven, singing the hymn of your unending glory. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please do feel free to sit a meal at this time. Glory and thanksgiving be to you, God our Creator, for the gift of your Son, born in human flesh. Obedient to your will, he died upon the cross, and by your power you raised him from the dead. And he broke the bonds of evil and set your people free to be his body in the world. On the night when he was given up to death, knowing that his hour had come, having loved his own, he loved them to the end. At supper with his friends, he took bread and offered you thanks. He broke the bread and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body. It is broken for you." After supper, he took a cup. He offered you thanks and gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant. It is poured out for you and for all, that sins may be forgiven. Do this in remembrance of me." We now obey your Son's command. We recall his blessed passion and death, his glorious resurrection and ascension, and we look for the coming of his kingdom. Made one, we offer you these gifts, and with them ourselves, a single, holy, living sacrifice. Hear us, most merciful Father, and send your Holy Spirit upon us, and be upon this bread and this wine, that overshadowed by the Spirit's life-giving power, they may be the body and blood of your Son, and we may be kindled with the fire of your love renewed for the service of your kingdom. Help us who are baptized into the fellowship of Christ's body to live and work to your praise and glory. May we grow together in unity and love until at last in your new creation we enter into our heritage in the company of the Virgin Mary, the apostles and prophets, and of all our brothers and sisters, living and departed. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, with whom and in you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be to you, Lord of all ages, world without end. Look, the bread of heaven is broken for the life of the world, and the wine of heaven is poured out for the healing of the nations, the gifts of God for the people of God. And as our Saviour Christ has commanded and taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. We remind you today and invite you to this table, reminding you that this table is not of any one church, but it is of the table of the Lord. It is made ready for those who love him and for those who want to love him. So come, you who have much faith, and come, you who have little. Come, you who have tried to follow, and come, all you who have failed. Come to this table, not because I invite you, but because God invites you to his table. Come and receive. Body of Christ. Thank you.
of the wine of Christ.
Thank you. you set up then? Oh, whatever. I don't even know.
Where's Joe? Huh?
Let us give thanks to the Lord, for he is gracious.
And his mercy endures forever.
Living God, increase in us the healing power of your love. Guide and direct us, that we may please you in all things, for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord. And God give you grace to be faithful stewards of his creation, rejoicing that you are made in God's own image, and seeking justice for those who do not share in the bounty of the earth. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you now and always. Amen.
So our final hymn, taking us out into this new week, this new month, this new season, is effectively a prayer asking God to give us joy and peace in our hearts. It also contains this week's special intelligence test for you all, because you'll notice that in the last verse, we've actually missed out a couple of lines. Let's see if you can work out what words should go in there in the blank space. Let's stand and sing. Give me oil in my lamp, keep me burning.
Just to let you know that busy week ahead of us.
Here in the church, we offer a food bank, but for pets. You know, because most people, if their pets are going hungry, they'll feed their pet first before they feed themselves. So on the first Tuesday of the month, we run a food bank for pets here. If you've got friends and that, family members, you've got pets and want some free food for the animals, just come along. It's not means tested or anything, it's just a free gift from the churches and from those who support the Edinburgh Adopting Cafe. So you're welcome to that. That's on Tuesday, running 10 to 12. Fellowship's starting up soon. That's on Wednesday night. If you want to come along for a time of fellowship, a cuppa and a chat. And we also have a time of coffee at St Mary's on this coming Saturday, and a swap shop, so you used to bring something colourful, but you're not getting my colours, it's my colours. But if you've got colourful things, colourful cups, colourful books, it's basically anything with a colour, which I think covers anything. So come along to that. And then tonight there's a special praise and worship service you've picked up in the service. There's a barbecue going on for the last few days, and all the churches in Dalkeith came together. And there's a special evening of praise tonight at 6 o'clock at St John's Church across from Morrison's. And then we're looking forward to our brains being teased now.
Yes.
Hopefully not too much.
Not too much,
okay. So come and join us for our quiz evening. You can come as an individual and we'll try and fit you into a team. But if you're coming as a team, it's kind of four in a team. And I think we've got a good number of 60 signed up, I thought. Okay. Ish, round about there. So we're looking forward to that evening. So come and enjoy. And it's a BYOB evening. That's bring your own brain. Okay? We're not using Google. Also, if you want to bring your own refreshments, that's fine, but we'll be providing the stovies and that. And there are tickets on sale, I think. Rebecca's got some. Rebecca's waving her hand saying, I've got tickets, you can buy them from me. And others. Anne's got some of them. That's excellent. Anyway, have you enjoyed your day, Millie May? Millie May, have you enjoyed the day? Has it been good? Are you having a party now? You're having a party? Excellent. Well, we're going to have a party here. You know what we need for a party? What do you need? You need cake. Yeah. Yeah? You want to come and see our cake?
What?
We've got a special cake. Come and see the cake. I'll take it. Oh, it's a special cake.
Careful.
And whose name's that? Whose name's that? That your name? That's your name. So it's to celebrate your baptism, and I'm hoping that you're a very kind girl. Are you a kind girl? Yeah, excellent. Because I'm hoping that you'll share it with me. You don't have to share it with anybody else. You know, me and you can have cake. You know, will we share it with everyone? Yeah, okay, everyone can get a bit. That means I only get a small bit. Anyway,
you only need a small bit.
I don't need any bit. Right, so we're going to let you take that, and then we'll get Mum and grandparents. Mum, want to come out and help as well? Is your Mum, is she coming to help? There you go. It's your special name, Mum, as well. There's no Millie May without Mum, is it? Yeah. Wear that, just leave it in the back. So Andrew, send us out for some coffee.
Let's stand together. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.